Shabbat Shalom. It is my pleasure to welcome Rabbi Stein, our brand new assistant rabbi, and his family to Congregation Beth Israel. They recently arrived from Australia and are previously from my old country, of course, the United States. This is an initial video that will become a weekly video in Devar Torah by either Rabbi Stein or myself, and on occasion, Rabbi David Blumen, who is our Rabbi of Youth and Young Adult Outreach. It is my pleasure now to ask Rabbi Stein to share with us some words of Torah.
Thank you, Rabbi Infeld. I'm very excited to now be a part of the community here at Beth Israel and in the broader Jewish community in Vancouver. As you heard from Rabbi Infeld, I just spent the past several years, past 5 years, living and working in Australia, in Melbourne, which is the one word I can say with the accent, Melbourne. I grew up, though, in the San Francisco area, and my parents still live there. My wife's family is in Chicago, so really we're all over the place. Chicago, though, is known for its amazing architecture. Some of the most famous buildings, especially skyscrapers, are in downtown Chicago. Now, one of them, the second tallest building right now in Chicago, has on the top of it the word Trump. And you may know that here in Vancouver, I think the second tallest building in Vancouver soon is also going to have that name on it. Now, I'm not going to get into politics right now, but it strikes me that sometimes it seems we have a culture of putting our names on things. And that can be a great thing, and I'll get into that in a moment, but sometimes making a name for oneself is not so positive. And we have an example of that in the weekly Torah portion. Of all the parashot, the weekly Torah portions in the Torah, I think only six are named after people. There's Noah, there's Sarah, Yitro, Balak, Pinchas, and then this week's antagonist, Korach. Now, he wanted to make a name for himself, certainly, and he did, but not in a good way. He challenges Moses' leadership, saying, "You, Moses, have gone too far. For all the community are holy, all of them, and the Lord is in their midst. God is with everyone. Then why do you raise yourself above the Lord's congregation?" He's yelling and he's screaming and he has all these people with him. He may have had a decent point. Why can't others communicate with God? But it's the way he makes his point that causes Korach to be vilified by the Bible and our tradition. He attacks, he accuses, he exaggerates, and he does it all without showing respect. In fact, he's held up as the quintessential way to not have an argument. But I said I get back to a positive way of making a name for ourselves. We see names in hospitals. I was just at VGH the other day. Concert halls, shuls. It's not a new tradition. You can find shuls that are dug up in archaeological digs from 2,000 years ago with the name of who donated for this or for that. And the reason why it can be such a wonderful thing is it can really help perpetuate the ideals and values of a loved one. It can encourage others to give. And so I think as I reflect on putting our names on things in positive ways and negative ways, I hope that this week and in this year, as we watch people try to make names for themselves in politics, in the media, in entertainment, often using words of attack and derision, let's remember that it is when we frame our words with respect and care that our arguments and statements can endure. And when we do that, we can truly, in a positive way, make a name for ourselves. Shabbat Shalom.
I want to ask all of us to please join us next Friday night, a week from today, as we welcome Rabbi Stein and his family with a Shabbat with a Difference service followed by a dinner. Also, please join us for two important communal events that are taking place over the course of this next week here at Congregation Beth Israel. Firstly, this coming Sunday night at 7 p.m. is Memories of Musenberg, a very special exhibit about a vacation spot in South Africa where many South African Jews over the course of the last 100 years have spent time vacationing. Secondly, a week from this Sunday here at Congregation Beth Israel, the Canadian Friends of Hebrew University will have their summer program. We look forward to seeing you then as well. Shabbat Shalom.